Hey guys, and welcome to another one. So today we're going to be looking at the Hikvision no resource issue. So this is quite a common issue with a 4-channel NVR. That's why we're talking about this model specifically. And I'm going to show you a quick little demo in a minute of the issue. But essentially, what happens is on the live view, it will come up no resource and you won't see anything. I mean, this is not great from obviously for Hikvision when you plug in all your cameras, and it means you have to change settings and things like that, but it doesn't affect your recording. This is the most important thing. The reason your NVR is doing this is to protect your recording. It's so you don't overload the NVR like you would a PC by loading up loads of different apps and different softwares, and then your PC gets really slow and crashes. No, the NVR is protecting its recording, so you have full 4K recording on all channels all the time, 24/7. Okay, so this means your live view will be sacrificed in some ways. Okay, I mean, you can't get everything from you can't just make extra power. Okay, but we have found a couple of little solutions, a couple of tricks, and our solutions, they don't reduce the quality, even though if you're still getting the issue, then you might have to go down that avenue if this is an issue for you. But like I said, only if you want to view live, this is a problem. If you don't care about the live view and all you care about is recording, then I'll probably say switch off this video now because it doesn't concern you. All right. So what I'm going to do now is flip over to our NVR and I'll show you the issue live. Okay. I'll see you in a sec. Okay. So on our NVR, as you can see, it looks like one camera is not working, but if I click on the camera, it's working. Okay. And now number two is gone. Oh no, what's going on? I mean, the problem is with this, it's just random. Okay, now two cameras have gone. Well, when I say gone, I mean they haven't gone. It's just the live view is struggling to put out a high definition picture while it's still recording. Okay, but like I said, there's nothing to particularly worry about. But if you do want a good live view, all right, we've got the solution coming up right now. Stay tuned. Okay, so the number one way to get rid of this problem is an easy one. Just switch to the substream for the live view. Okay, there's a little button on the live view you can click on. It will switch the substream, select all your cameras. You don't even have to select all of them. You can have one at mainstream and three or substream usually be fine. And that's fine. And you're not going to really notice any lack of quality on the live view. I mean, when you've got four cameras all next to each other in the boxes, substream is a perfectly good picture. Okay, so this is, you're not going to lose any compression, you're not going to lose any quality in cameras. I mean, this is a simple solution, all right? But there is one issue with it. When you see my little live demo coming up in a second, what happens is when you click on one camera to get a full picture, to see the mainstream, and you go back to your live view, it will go back to main view, okay? So some people are not too happy with that, okay? But if you just want to really get rid of this problem completely, and you want to be able to flick over from camera to camera and not having this issue, then enable H.264 compression instead of H.265. H.265 is now commonly the standard compression on IP cameras, so you have to flip over and change it to H.264. And you're seeing the little demo how it affects the NVR. It does free up a little bit of space for it. Okay, so if this doesn't work though, I mean, this is what we recommend. If this doesn't work, then what you have to do is reduce the quality in the camera. All right, so Hikvision IP cameras, they come really high frame rates, really high bit rates. So you can reduce it and you're really not gonna notice anything in the quality, all right? This is what other videos recommend to do. And they even recommend to reduce the resolution of the camera. I mean, oh my God, I would not recommend that, okay? I mean, what is the point of spending all that money on a high resolution camera in order just to reduce it? Okay, we do not recommend this. But you can tweak it and you really will notice any changes in the quality. And plus, if you do reduce the frame rate and the bit rate, it will extend your expected amount of recording you can get. Okay, so that's the solution. And I'm going to show you live how it works. And I'll see you there. Thanks. Okay, so on NVR now, I'm going to show you how to get rid of this no resource issue. Like I said, the simple way is, and you will get no reduction in compression or quality, is just to switch the sub stream. Okay, this is just like your phone stream. And look at the quality. The quality is no different. Okay, you see, you can even have one on mainstream. Okay, but I'm switch them all to substream just for the purposes of this. And then you've got nice smooth streaming. So if you have a display or something, you could use this. But it won't look what happens when you start messing around and looking at individual cameras. Okay, it comes straight back. Okay. And if you leave it, it starts flickering and yeah, unpredictable. So now they're all back to mainstream, you see. So even though you flip them to substream, there's no way of keeping it on substream, unfortunately. Maybe they'll introduce a feature in the future, or if someone does know about a feature, that would be great. But that's one way, just for a live display. But now let's go change the camera settings and see what happens then. Okay, so under record, under parameter, we could change the cameras to H.264 compression. Okay. All right, this one's a bit of an older camera, so it's already on H.264. Okay. So let's just give that a second to take effect. As you see already, then live view, what are we on? We're on mainstream on all of them, okay? So they're saying switch to substream, we're not gonna switch. And we're on mainstream and it's working, okay? I'm not gonna say it doesn't come up. If you click on the camera, okay, no resource comes up, but then it goes away, all right? So I think that's not too bad. And I think it's a good compromise. Instead of losing quality, just to lose a little bit less recording time. All right, like I said, if you're still getting issues and you're really annoyed with it, then you're gonna have to reduce that quality a little bit. But I think for a four channel NVR, losing a little bit of recording, just to enable H.264 is a fair enough compromise. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you now understand the no resource issue a little bit more, and I'll catch you on the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe if it helped you, and catch you later. Thanks.